NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 55 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And in our previous episode, we started this rollability scores method. We wrote it, and our specs are passing but the road pirates are angry with us. So, and we've got some opportunity to refactor those specs that we wrote last time. So we'll try to break this out. The module's starting to get long, and we'll see if we can resolve the ABC size on this and the line length, which will make potentially the module length even worse, but then we'll try to break that down into smaller source files, which we'll include from the main item there. So first thing we're going to do is we'll create another smaller method here. Lab keys equals, it'll have the similar fix long, and then going to want to have the condition here where this should, if I wrote it correctly, continue to pass. Oh, it does not. So it's returning nil there. Not see if that fixes it. So this, for one thing, needs to be a constant. Debugging here. Oh, I'm pretty sure I know what I broke, is that if you don't pass it in, it still needs to. It still needs to have it in the array if it's nil. That's what I'm breaking. All right, so back to the drawing board. Go the other direction on this now that we have ability score keys. Essentially reduces the need for the second. No, we still want it. But that will give us the complete picture, I'm pretty sure. This is no longer necessary. That seems to have worked. That reduces the number of lines that we've got in our code. Down to two items here, module length, which we've reduced by one, but we still need to do, and then line length. So take a look at line 121. It has too many lines. Okay with making that a disable enable method link item because there's no other way to do it. So we're down to one error, which is just our item there. I think we might be able to get away with I don't think we gain any benefit by making that a shorter method. So now we've got methods all passing and RuboCop is just angry with us about our method, our module length. So we'll start trying to break this down. We're going to create in the NerdDice folder a new file called class methods. Class methods here, class methods. We'll have still our module. This whole class into self block to start off with. All right, let's see if we have broken everything. Have not. So we're missing the, we still have too many lines, but we're missing the top level module documentation comment. So we'll deal with that after, but let's start breaking class methods down farther. So we'll create a subfolder here. And we'll start breaking down the methods into smaller source code files. Class methods, take that out. Put it in there. It'll require stuff. Let me see how I did it in NerdDice. Need to require from the root of the directory there. And then we can pretty much as long as we require these in the right order. Let's go public method by public method and add them that way. So we'll create a new file for total dice. Roll dice, roll ability scores, a Ruby file. Roll ability scores. Execute die roll. Refresh seed. All right. So for each of these, start off with this. And then we'll include them. Let me look at the logical order. So refresh seed, execute and die roll. It depends upon that. So we'll start with refresh seed here. Associated private methods. So we've got parse refresh options, reset appropriate seeds. out into this. See if I broke anything. I did not. Maybe actually save the file. Still did not break anything. That's encouraging, although my coverage has gone down, so we'll take a look at that in a minute. I think that might just be because I've got those empty classes that aren't covered, so not a cause for concern yet. All right, now we want execute die roll to go next, I believe. Execute die roll depends on get number generator, increment and evaluate refresh seed. This is why you write your specs, because there is an opportunity to create all kinds of problems when you're refactoring like this, and you want to be confident that you're not breaking anything. Refresh seed. So I think those belong. Probably all in the refresh seed method or module there. Got that moved out. Now go back to class methods. So we've got total dice, roll dice, and roll ability scores left. Total dice. We will move out. roll dice. We will move out. Ability scores. We will move out. So the original Alright, so that's all still working, which is good. We've got indentations and empty line stuff. We'll take care of that. See what we have left. So missing top level documentation. You know what? I never moved them out of NerdDice, so I could have been breaking stuff all along. And then none the wiser, which I probably have been. Still passing. We've got 100% coverage. That's encouraging. All right, and then missing top level documentation comments. So let's refactor our comments. Which needs to be updated anyway, so I'll modify the top level comment there, and then we'll move on from there. Pause. Write this for class methods. All right, so in the class methods, I essentially just referenced the other method files. Now let's take a look. So I kind of want something similar to what we've got with the total dice method for all the rest of these. So we'll start with configuration. Write these. So I've got the module level comment on configuration. Let's see how we're doing. RuboCop. Down to 4 now. Die roll, refresh seed, roll ability scores, and roll dice. Cool. Do that. So we've got our comments for execute die roll. Move down to refresh seed. So we've got refresh seed. Down to 2. So we need roll ability scores and roll dice. Do this one. I got my comment on roll ability scores. And now we'll go to roll dice. So as I was writing the method for roll dice here, I realized that I had an incorrect syntax in the total dice comment, so I fixed that. It was in, I'll control Z for a moment here. You can see here it was in the hash argument there, and it's now an options hash, so that would not work. So I fixed that in the comment. The roll dice is there. We should now be able to pass RuboCop and we've got passing values on the rest of this stuff. So we will log. Take a look at our diff. So there's a lot going on here. I think I'm going to keep these two commits separate. So take a look at our log here. So let me do an interactive rebase. We'll reword both commits. Make sure that I closed all my files here. Looks like I have. Let's give it a shot. Reword both of them. Start with this one. So I've got my first commit. So I've got my second commit message. And we've successfully rebased, but I have not signed either of these commit messages yet, so I'll do that. So in video number 35, I went through a little bit more detail, but we're gonna redo this git rebase. And for each of them, instead of pick, we're going to edit to make sure that they show up as signed. So, and no edit sign, pa pause while I sign it. Continue. Still got the two commits. They should show up as signed. We'll try pushing them. And check things out on GitHub. So while that action is running, we'll take a look at our branch here. So our two new commits are both verified, which is what we want. Let that finish. That was successful. We can go into our backlog now. Move this to done, and we'll pick up in the next video.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.